Welcome to this live-streamed Choral Evensong service here at St Paul's Melbourne as we commemorate the eighth week of Pentecost. Our cathedral is built on the traditional lands of the Wurundjeri people of the Kulin Nation, sovereign lands never ceded. I acknowledge and pay my respects to First Nations people who are with us tonight and engaging with our live stream. We at St Paul's are prayerfully committed to the ongoing work of reconciliation in our nation. My name is Heather Pataka. I'm the Archdeacon of Melbourne and precentor of our cathedral. And I hope that wherever you are tonight, that St Paul's can be home for you as we worship together. The order of service is available on the website, and please do join in singing the hymn with us. I hope that you enjoy spending this time together with us in reflection, prayer, and song. And may God bless you richly.
To the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Ghost. Here begins the 14th chapter of the book of the prophet Hosea. Return, O Israel, to the Lord your God, for you have stumbled because of your iniquity. Take words with you and return to the Lord. Say to him, take away all guilt, accept that which is good, and we will offer the fruit of our lips. Assyria shall not save us. We will not ride upon horses. We will say no more, our God, to the work of our hands. In you the orphan finds mercy. I will heal their disloyalty. I will love them freely, for my anger has turned from them. I will be like the dew to Israel. He shall blossom like the lily. He shall strike root like the forests of Lebanon. His shoots shall spread out. His beauty shall be like the olive tree, and his fragrance like that of Lebanon. They shall again live beneath my shadow. They shall flourish as a garden. They shall blossom like the vine. Their fragrance shall be like the wine of Lebanon. O Ephraim, what have I to do with idols? It is I who answer and look after you. I am like an evergreen cypress. Your faithfulness comes from me. Those who are wise understand these things. Those who are discerning know them. For the ways of the Lord are right, and the upright walk in them, but transgressors stumble in them. Here ends the first lesson.
Thank you. Here begins the 15th chapter of the Holy Gospel according to St. John. I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine grower. He removes every branch in me that bears no fruit. Every branch that bears fruit, he prunes to make it bear more fruit. You have already been cleansed by the word that I have spoken to you. Abide in me as I abide in you. Just as the branch cannot bear fruit by itself unless it abides in the vine, neither can you unless you abide in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. Those who abide in me and I in them bear much fruit, because apart from me, you can do nothing. Whoever does not abide in me is thrown away like a branch and withers. Such branches are gathered, thrown into the fire, and burned. If you abide in me and my words abide in you, ask for whatever you wish, and it will be done for you. My Father is glorified by this, that you bear much fruit and become my disciples. As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. I have said these things to you so that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be complete. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I do not call you servants any longer, because the servant does not know what the master is doing. But I have called you friends, because I have made known to you everything that I have heard from my Father. You did not choose me, but I chose you. And I appointed you to go and bear fruit, fruit that will last, so that the Father will give you whatever you ask him in my name. I am giving you these commands so that you may love one another. Here ends the second lesson.
As we remain standing, we join together in affirming the faith of the Church in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Of this night, for the love of thy only Son, our Savior. Let us pray. Loving God, hear our prayers for your world, for the church, and for ourselves. We pray for the well-being of our fragile planet, for the preservation of nature, for wise use, just sharing, and conservation of resources, and a concerted effort globally and personally to manage climate change. Help our focus to be on your holiness, free from greed, remembering the wonder and goodness of your mighty deeds of creation, and knowing the freedom of being satisfied with simplicity. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for all the peoples of the world, for all whose daily life is such a struggle, those who live in the constant shadow of war, civil unrest, or terrorism in so many places, that they would know your strength and peace. We pray for refugees who have left their homes in search of peace and security, and those who long for freedom from oppression and injustice, but are trapped by their circumstances. Release your people, that they might know the only true freedom, which is your gift. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for your church worldwide, that all who commit their lives to your service might live out and tell out that you are the God who works wonders and redeems your people. We pray for Justin, Archbishop of Canterbury, and all those attending Lambeth, that they will value the opportunity to hear and understand diverse opinions and directions. Guide, strengthen, and bless all who minister and worship here. Give to us the freedom of those who know the delight of following in your way, released from slavery to sin, redeemed in your love. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for those who especially need to know your love in their trouble or distress, the lonely, the sorrowing, the sick, and the bereaved, those who are lost, and those who have lost hope. Release them and us from the grip of anxiety, fear, or despair, that trusting in your strength and reminded that you are the God who works wonders, we may all know the freedom of life in your loving care. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We give you thanks for the faithful servants of every age, for those we have seen set free from fear or grief to honour and follow Christ, those whose lives have excelled to show the fruits of your Spirit, those whom we have loved, and those who have worshipped in this cathedral. Release us from all that binds us in the past. With all your saints, may we enter into the freedom of your gift of everlasting life. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We conclude together with the grace. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen.
I invite you to stand with me as together we sing our dismissal hymn. God is love, let heaven adore him. We stand and sing.
Thank you.
shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon you and give you peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be amongst you and remain with you now and always. Amen.